Okay, if anybody's watching this on YouTube, this was a live recording over on Ustream.tv. Unfortunately, I started doing the project before I realized I didn't hit record. So now I'm recording on the painting part. You missed the whole cleaning part of this shoe. These shoes I painted last year, love them, wore them once, and they started to crack across the bridge of my foot after a couple hours. So I've spent over an hour cleaning this one shoe. And I got it down to the oil leather. These were a pair of Danskos that I got years ago. I never wore them. So I'm going to try to mimic this on here, but I'm only going to do one at a time at this point. And I've decided I'm going to paint it all white first. I've taped off with some black artist tape to try to keep the sole kind of clean. And because these are the colors I'm going to use, I'm not sure how they'll work against the really dark brown color, if that'll alter the way they look. So I'm going to put white on first. And that's what we're doing now. I don't know where to start. Just start. That's the best thing to do. Just start. So this is Angelus leather paint. And it suggests a couple of thin coats. Here's the name brand of what it is. You gonna focus for me? Probably not. On. Really? Well, okay. So it's not going to, it's Angel Us, A-N-G-E-L-U-S, and it's leather paint. So that's what we're going to try this time. The last time I did it for the fail, I gessoed the shoes and use Golden's fluid acrylics, and then sealed it with an acrylic sealer, just like I was painting a canvas. How did I get the paint off? Oh my gosh. Well, I started using a wire brush, peeling it with my fingers, and then Rihanna had a great idea to use tape, so I used some duct tape, and that actually helped pull the majority of it off. There was still some left, and I used a magic eraser and the Angelus leather preparer, which is a cleaner that took off pretty much everything. That worked really well. So now, this isn't going to be much fun just watching me paint all this white, but it must be done. Does anybody watch that new TV show, This Is Us? I think that's a really good show. I just watched a couple episodes that I missed and I had recorded before I came down here today. It was not easy to get the paint off. That was a painful process. I can't believe it was that hard to get off, but it cracked so easily. Like, seriously? Is that fair? And I'm not being too overly careful about this. I just want to get a coat down to cover some of the brown so the next layers of colors look like the right colors. Okay. This isn't using much of this paint at all. I was thinking that little tiny jar, am I going to have enough to do two shoes plus some white in the design? And I think I'll have plenty. All right. Oh, so boring. If you're on YouTube, you may want to just speed ahead. And if you don't realize that on YouTube, you do have an ability to change the speed of what you're watching, or just slide the timeline bar forward by little chunks of time to see where I am 5 or 10 minutes or a half an hour from here. Unless you like watching paint dry. Stay with me. Wasn't thinking about putting tape on this leather trim. I guess I could just paint it, but I'd like to keep that exposed. If I can manage to do it. Black Mirror. I've never even heard of that show, Gayla. I've been out of the loop, I'm telling you. I am not kidding about that. Sorry, I'm so quiet. This is a straight edge here. I keep trying to peek at the chat. I know I'm gonna pay for that with some schmutz on here. This a thin coat. It says to use thin coats. All right. White coat number one. Paul says it's cheaper to buy another pair of shoes, Pat. He doesn't care. But I can't buy shoes that look like that, Paul. Don't you see the beauty here? Patty, tell me about the. Oh, hang on. You just flipped off the screen there, Jen. Oh, Remy. Yeah, I did that. Actually, I showed that stuff earlier, which was not recorded. So, since this has to dry, I'll show you real quick. We had several different classes. One was, and this is the Remy REME, Remy Retreats, that Jody Ohl and Jean Skipper do. They usually go to Ocracoke, but now they have a home studio in Vass, North Carolina. It's VASS. It's right outside of Pinehurst. And they have a really cool studio there that they use studio space with Jan McNichols, who owns Creative Studios North Carolina. So this time they wanted to do a Remy at their home studio instead of so far away. So we had gathered on Wednesday and left Sunday afternoon. One of the projects, this was actually the last project we did, but I have it sitting closely. Jean Skipper does mixed media jewelry. She uses a lot of copper in her work. So we did what she called Sketch and Etch was the name of her class. And we each got a copper bracelet blank. And we etched a design on it with acid. And of course, I did pictographs. All right. Focus. And then we patinaed it. And then I put some rub and buff in the blue on it. Why won't anything focus this morning? It was focusing earlier pretty good. Crap. Well, you get the idea. So anyway, the pictographs are raised and the acid etched off etched off all the rest of it and left the images that we put on it with ink raised. And then we hammered it into the right shape. But of course, because my wrist is so big, I can wear it if I don't move. Yeah, I'm not going to put a second coat of white on, Jan. I thought the same thing. So it doesn't quite work on my bigger wrist. I always buy an 8-inch bracelet and it's loose enough. They're usually loose enough to shake on me, but this was a 6-inch blank, which is a standard blank. I'm not a standard person. But anyway, that was one of them. And then the abstract canvas we did was a really cool project. However, I don't like mine. I'm going to paint over these. I just can't. Jody has such a wonderful eye and technique for her layers and depths. It's two canvases. You can't see them all together, right? It's two. So I'm trying to move this so I don't hit the wire on the camera. I put some of my tribal sticks on there. Oops. I'm trying to show the metallic on there, but I can't really turn it the right. It's too big. Another tribal stick. That's my favorite parts, of course. So I wasn't pleased with this at all, to tell you the truth. I love the techniques and I love just about everybody else's canvases. Didn't love mine. I will try it again. And then we made Jean and Jody did a joint project where Jody guided us through painting. And then Jean took over with some of her mixed media cold connection techniques. And we did a project they called, what did they call it? Gayla, do you remember? Winged Hearts? Hearts in Flight? No. I forget. But they did all this series of these wooden, long, skinny wooden hearts. That they cut out and we had unfinished wood. So we started with this. We gessoed everything black. And then we painted it. And then did all this stuff on it. So starting at the top, this is one of those polymer clay molds that I had that I patinaed and did the metal stuff on. And I like anchors. Anchors mean something to my family. Chelsea always called her mom her anchor. So you guys know that we have two mermaids at sea. We lost my sister-in-law, Janine, and Chelsea's baby, who was her granddaughter, Janine's granddaughter. Both of them were cremated and laid to rest at sea. So we say we have two mermaids. So here's Here's Janine and here's Brinley. This is another polymer clay mold. This little cold connection here I left loose, so it moved. I made these with Jean in Ocracoke 2 years ago at Remy, and it has a little sand dollar we found on the beach in it. So I thought that was kind of cool. And they had a bunch of stuff we could use. These are old white upholstery tacks. They're antique. The plastic coating on it was breaking apart like dust when I went in to use it. Then I just strung kind of copper wire around everything just to give it another dimension. These beads I bought from Jean at the last Create, which I don't know, 4 years ago or so. But they're really funky, cool beads. And I never used them, so I'll put them on this. There's more down here. And then this is one of my stencils. That's what I always say is the rules of our house. We have house rules. That's what the house rules are. And Kathy was sitting across from me with Gala, and Kathy had this. Can you see it? Is it going to work? Live, love, laugh. Little metal piece. So I put that on there. And this one I also did in Ocracoke. And if you can see it, the word in there says laugh. And this is resin and a bezel that we did with Jean in Ocracoke. I added another mermaid. I've had these and I haven't used them forever. So she's like a 3D mermaid. These are some of the black upholstery tacks. And this medallion or tag or whatever you want to call it is brass. I got this in the packet of stuff I got from Jean with these beads in it, like a variety pack of stuff years ago. But I was born in 1957, so that means something to me. So I painted the 57 on here. I got a lamp work bead on here and another one of Jean's beads I bought from her, wire wrapped on the end. And Jean gave me this. This was, she's going to do a class on this. This is resin and a copper bezel that's got primary elements mixed in the resin and little ripped up sheets of music tissue that were in. Let me see if I can hit the light right so you can see what that looks like. It's gorgeous if you see it in person. See the primary elements in there? And the music. So I got a little feather hanging there because I love feathers. And the wings, I just traced my mermaid tail stencil. And these are just foil. They won't last over time, of course. I'll replace them. But those were my wings were mermaid tails. So that's the other, that's the third project that we did. So, you know, it means, each thing on here means something to me. So that's what I did. So, anywho, let's see where we are. Thank you. Add a piece of candy and not me. And you didn't give me anything to add. Grief. Oh my God. That's getting pretty dry. That's going pretty quick. I'm going to very lightly heat gun it. Uh-oh, what was that? Oh, my iron just snuffed it. I have a big project in mind for down here when I take my time off around the holidays. I told Dave. Oh, thanks, Beagle. I don't care for them. I don't like the way they look. I want to try to get them looking more with more depth and stuff in them. I mean, I do some stuff that I really like that I do. So I'm not trying to be critical of myself. I'm just saying, yeah, I don't like that one. Like the heart. I like the bracelet. Not wild about what I did with the canvases. That's why God made gesso. Ugh. Okay. Oh, I was saying between Christmas and New Year's when I take some time off. Dave's got some hours he has to burn too. So I told him I'm going to ask Santa Claus for some different storage options. And I'm not 100% convinced how I'm going to go with that. I thought that I was going to go with some of the, if you guys know the Container Store, they have those stacked drawers of wire bins, and then you can buy a countertop that connects them all, right? My friend Terry from Queen's Inc. has her home studio set up with those that wrap around like three walls of her studio. And she's got tons of stuff in there and they're really heavy duty. I thought I would do that and move around some of the stuff and get rid of the stuff I don't use anymore. I've got too much stuff down here. Gotta make room for what I use. But now that I'm looking at it back here, I love these IKEA Alex drawers. Let's see, how can I do this? No, taking the camera off the tripod. Let's see. Ooh, this is a mess. Let's see if you guys can see this. All right, see these white drawers down here? These are, I don't know, they're probably 30 inches wide, and they're really, they're narrow, but they're really deep, and they hold tons of stuff in these, and I have two of those. And then I have a tall one over here. But on top of it, I just have these smaller bins with crap in it, and then I got this, oops, I got this bookshelf over top of it with all this stuff in there that I don't need right there. So I can't decide. I'm going to keep these. I love these. I don't know if I want to go up, buy another set of these two, and go up a layer. Of course, I can't sit and see in the top layers, but I'm tall enough that I could. Or if I want to just completely rethink what's on top here and add those container store bins elsewhere. I don't know. It's quite the puzzle. Yeah. I wish I could, Joan. That would, Lord knows what that would cost. But you know, I collect all this stuff and use it for a time and then I move on to something else. And a lot of times I go back to my favorites, but some of the stuff I haven't touched for years. Like I had, when I first started getting into this stuff, I had this period where I was making a bunch of tags with sprays and using salt on them. And then I was putting the colored grommets. And I have all these grommets that I was putting in the eye of the hole of the tags. And when I first started doing this, I did it thinking, oh, I can make these really cool, funky tags to attach to my lamp work jewelry that I was actually doing. And I ended up getting away from doing the jewelry. But whatever. I'll figure it out. How can you find anything, Patty? I can find it usually. There's a few things that evade me. But I can usually find what I need. I have all my favorites in arm's reach right around me. And the stuff that's on that bookshelf, I never really... It's just like storage. It's not stuff that I would use. It's previous projects, books... there's very little off the top shelving area that I actually use, which means it's taken up prime real estate where it doesn't need to be. So if I make holes with what I don't use and get that stuff that I still want to keep move somewhere else, you know. Patty, I have both those. We'll send you pictures of how they are set up. Oh, cool. Thanks. Well, I have to watch what I put in the wire bins, but I've not had anything leak yet, and I do have some things in wire. The stuff that's in the drawers wouldn't be that I have in my Alex drawers. They're rubber stamps, bottles of my little inks that just never tip over. They're, you know, little short fat ones, but they're in the drawers. My washi tape's in one of those drawers. My jelly plate stuff's in one of those drawers. And I have two of the smaller, narrower... deeper drawer Alex is underneath each side of this table. This table was just a table. It was just flat. It's like a square U. It's like this. And I had room to slide two of those sets, one on each side underneath here. So I made it kind of like a desk instead of just a table. Oh, good. I'm glad Jean's going out. Okay. What time is it? 12:51. Okay. All right, so here we are. Myself situated. Now, oops, oh, look, it's got a little brush in it. Huh. Maybe I can just use the little brush that comes with it. Well, let's try it, see what happens. So, what do I do here? I want to try to do them like I did them before. Oop, oh, look, it's going to be tricky and messy. Great. This looks completely different than my other purple. It's real milky. But if it works, then it works. Well, not wild about this color so far. Not wild. All right. It'll be easier to pour it out and use a bigger brush. It might be, but it's very runny. And pouring it out, I think, will be a mess. And it seems like I have more control with that little bit there. So I'm going to try using these while the spirit moves me. Yeah, probably more layers. I don't mind them mixing. I'm going to see what it looks like. You can always wash the brush off with some water. Kind of like the smeary look where they're blending. And this is a first layer, so. And it's abstract. It's not like I'm painting a masterpiece. God forbid. I do like where it's mixing though. I wish these colors came out true, though. I don't know if you guys are seeing these right or not, but this is a really pretty bright turquoise, and a purple. I'll put pictures when I get finished out on my. Marlou! Hello! Good to see you. I'm repainting my shoes I did last year, or whenever I did them, last year, I guess. It took me about over an hour to clean one of them off, so I'm just doing one at a time right now. I'm just getting a coat, a base coat down here, slapping it on. I think I used my fingers the last time. You guys remember? I don't remember. Yeah, I like the mixing. All right. Yeah, I know. It looks like cobalt on mine, too, and it's not. Yeah, these are just like very greeny turquoise colors, these two. This one's almost like a mint, bright mint. I'm gonna put some more purple around this part of this band here. They are, Jennifer. These are Angelus paints. The first time I did this, I used golden fluid. And I painted the shoes just like I would paint a canvas. I gessoed them. I did the paints. I stenciled and splattered and put rings on them. And then I sealed them. And they cracked the first time I wore them. Darn it. Get this different color in here. Uh-oh. And this one doesn't have a little brush. This color is called Miami Vice. So we will be doing a little brush on this one. Let's try. What the hell? I think I am going to use this brush. It just is giving me a smoother finish than the other one. The Miami Vice tune, you mean, Sophia? Hey, Star. Yeah, that's weird. All the rest of them have brushes. I don't know. Did the white one? The white one didn't. I wonder if the black and the gold do. Nope. The gold does. Very strange. Oh well. I'm going to put that right there. That's too close to the other one, I think. Oops. I need another brush on the floor. That's to make my, Gail, that's to make my foot look long and petite. How do you do that for an 11? I do not know. Sorry, guys, I'm not looking at the chat right now. The sound of silence. You should be thankful for that. The more I'm silent, the less chance I got to say something goofy. Okay. This one is called South Beach. I got Miami Vice and South Beach. What's the purple one called? Oh, Violet. And that one's just called Turquoise. Well, they got boring again. Actually, I seem to remember when I bought these that there was like a special color palette set or something they were selling that had this Miami colors in it. Although these are the only colors that I got, so. I don't know. Well, there we go. That's where it's headed. Let's get some purple back here. I'm zoning out. I'm going to come back and hit it with a probably another coat in places. I wish these colors, I mean, Dave even put all new lights in the ceiling down here for me. And you can really see the difference. Like the ones he has over my head, there's three different sets of the fluorescent panels. And they're the ones that are the daylight bulbs that if you get the full color spectrum. And I can see the difference by the ones across the room look very yellow. And these look more true white. But this, it's still not, we're trying everything to get these colors to come out right, but it's not working. Not working. Let's put some of this mint back here. This works. I'm going to start painting more shoes. I've been wearing those Allegria. I think they pronounce it Allegria. I always want to say Allegria, but that's the allergy medicine, I think. But anyway, they're a comfort shoe. And they come in a lot of really funky colors and patterns. And I have a few of them. Nothing saying I can't paint and add a little something something on there. Let's go with this darker one again. This one or this one? This one. I'm not looking forward to cleaning this other shoe off, I can tell you that. But I will start with the tape. And bring in the magic eraser a little earlier into the process than the last one. All right, well, and this has to dry. And that may take a little while. So what I may do is something that I have to get done. Whoops. Anyway, so I'm going to sit this off to the side. And here's the colors. They're not going to show right. But that's the first layer. Just getting some color munged on there. Mixing it up. It's turquoise and three shades of teal. Looks cobalt, but it is not. Okay. No. Very stealthy, Gayla. Let's see. I need to find... Aha! All these mason jars last year I painted for Chelsea's shower. We're doing it when she was pregnant for the little girl. And as most of you probably know, she lost that baby at 7 months. She's my little mermaid tail that's on my heart. But she is expecting again. And this one's a little boy. So we had to... She lost the baby just like the week before her shower last time. So I need to go in and repaint some of these mason jars, we're going to put water and baby's breath in them. So I got to... We have this corally kind of color on some of them with the teal. So I got to fix those. And she's going to do little pops of navy in the baby's room with teal. So, I can keep the teal ones that I have. And I need to redo the pink ones. So my first thought for some of these polka dot ones, which I'm just going to try to paint navy polka dots over the pink ones. I'm going to find my applicator. My polka dot maker. Just the right size. That's the right size. All right. Yeah, we're going to put water and maybe in the clear ones put some seashells or something in the bottom and some water and baby breath and maybe hang like a little piece of twine with a sand dollar or starfish or something on it because it's going to be a nautical theme. We come from a very nautical family. And we've always, all of us have always been on the water all of our lives, so that's what Chelsea wants to put in the baby's room. We went shopping a couple weeks ago, and I took her to Hobby Lobby. She had never been to Hobby Lobby. There's not one on her side of town, and we have two of them over here. And we went in the, like, the home decor section and got a lot of little items for the room. She's keeping it pretty classic, and everything's gray and white, which is how it was for the baby girl, for Brinley. And then she was going to have the pops of the coral and a real baby teal, just in little pops here and there. The crib's white, trim's white. Everything else was real pale gray. And so now we're going to take out the coral and add navy for the boy. But she did some really cool stuff. She's making a shelf and painting it like a driftwood finish. And we got little items for that shelf. It's going to hang on the wall with, I don't know if you guys, any of you guys are boaters, but the cleats, the metal cleats that are mounted on the pier that you tie your boat to and lace the rope around, they're going to be two metal cleats on the wall. Do I have a picture? And use line, the boat, the rope that you tie the boat up with to string these three different shelves. Let's see if I have a picture she sent me when she was working on it. I just got a new phone recently, so... I got it. And the lamp, the lighting fixture she has in that room, it does a really cool thing to the walls, which she didn't know when she got it, but it looks like waves. Looks like you're underwater. So here's the shelf. Not finished yet, but here's the shelf. And see the light on the wall? It's this like shelly kind of crystal, shell-shaped crystals that is making that pattern. That wall is solid gray. But see the boat? Oh, crap. See the metal cleat up at the top? And then she painted the shelves and made them like a driftwood color. And then we got little oars and a ball of ship's twine and a little whale's tail. And here you can see more what that light. Oops, I got a glare. There's her little chair she'll nurse him in, and the gray and white rug. And the curtains. She's just testing out curtains now. She had a navy one up there. But anyway. Yeah, she's really excited, And we are trying to do everything we can do to make this nice and good, and praying every day that this one's going to be okay. You still see the pink from the inside, but anybody's going to come and look at the inside. Yeah, we'll just have to see pink. Brinley is the one that we lost. She lost Brinley when she was 7 months pregnant. That's who my little mermaid is over there. Her ashes, she was cremated, and we put her ashes at sea with Chelsea's mother, Janine. So I got to see her and hold her. I was in when she delivered her, and smooch her up and talk to her. And she had a priest come in to bless her, and she was cremated. And so Brinley... Oh, you just became a great aunt? Yep. Yep, I can't wait. We just went to dinner last night with Dave's, well, we call him stepson, although he's not, he was never married to his mother, but he was with her for 15 years and raised her boys, basically. And they both are married with kids now. And the youngest one, Daniel, has her little girl, Madison, who's just 8 months. And then the other, his brother, Ray, and his wife were there with their two that are probably 3 and 6, maybe 5 and 3. I don't know, somewhere in there. But it was fun. Some of these little pink edges are sticking out on me. I don't want them to get not round. Polka dots have to be circles, you know. Trying to squidge this a little bit to make them a little teeny tiny bit bigger than the pink. So, I've got to get this done. This is a good fill-in for drying time for the shoe. Maybe not for you guys, but the way my time is limited this year of late, I got to do it when I can do it. All right, so there's that one. I might come back and put little pops of turquoise in between them with a smaller dot. Actually, where am I going to put it? Well, we'll switch. I don't know if I have enough paint to. I'll have to mix some navy. To paint these solid jars over here. We painted so many of these jars when Chelsea and Pete got married. We used mason jars, clusters of mason jars for their centerpieces, for their guest tables. And we had a big one, a medium one, and a small one on each table that sat on a mirror, a round mirror. And we had... what do we have in them? Sand and shells and some. And some had, I think the big center one had a huge white hydrangeas in it, which were beautiful. And we had floating candles and the ones that had sand and water in them. And that cast really cool shadows and light from that mirror because it was an evening wedding, evening reception, and it made it really pretty when the lights went down and had all those glowing. After that, I swore I'd never paint another mason jar because she had probably 200 guests. I don't know how many tables that was. Divide that by 8. And then times 3 jars for each table, plus the wedding, the Pete and Chelsea's table. And thought, good Lord, I'm never gonna paint another mason jar. Here I am. But I'm happy to do these for sure. Chelsea's always wanted to have kids. She, even as a little girl, as she grew up, she mothered all of her little friends. She always took care of everybody. And then when she got old enough to get her first job, she actually worked at a Celebree Learning Center and had like 12 2-year-olds that she took care of. So I say a prayer every day that this pregnancy is going to be all good and she'll be able to start her little family. That was brutal last year, losing the little girl. There we These go pretty fast. Was thinking about maybe what I'll do on these pink jars is gesso them, and then I don't know if the tape will let me do it. I was thinking about navy and white stripes, but I don't know if I could tape it off. You know, with just painting on glass, it's not as the gesso will have some tooth, but will that peel right off the glass? That's the question. I might try one. That one that's around. There we go. Some more paint. You saw the pictures of my wedding and you like my dress? Well, I'm not sure what you saw, Ella, but I didn't wear a dress for our wedding. We both had on black. Well, I had on like a, I don't know what to call them other than gauchos was the old word, kind of a split long skirt that was black and a white capey kind of thing. And Dave had on black pants and a li white linen shirt. So basically, we both had on black bottoms and white tops. But did you maybe see a friend's wedding where I had on a bright blue long top that might have looked like a dress, possibly? That was at a friend's wedding, daughter's wedding. Trust me, you don't want to see these gams in a dress. You and Dave were in the period of white tops. So, oh, yep. That was it then. That was our wedding. Yeah, you don't want to see these gams in a dress. Just saying. All right, there's three polka dot navy ones. Now, I'm going to waste this paint on here and just maybe do this whole thing navy. See if it turns purple with this pink under it. Yeah, it was at a dock. It wasn't a pier. It was a deck on a restaurant that was right on the water, and there was a marina in the background, so it would have looked like a pier for sure. Yeah, we got married that year. It was we got married. We wanted the date 9/9/09, and that was a Wednesday. So we got married that Wednesday night, and we had just our closest family and friends there. It was like 42 of us, I think, for dinner after the wedding. And then that Saturday, we had a big party. We made sure everybody realized it's not a wedding reception and to expect all the wedding reception stuff. It was just a big party. And we made it very casual. And I told them I in the invitations that the groom's going to be in shorts and a golf shirt. So don't buy a new outfit. Come to be comfortable and have fun. We're not worried about all the formal crap. Well, I didn't say crap on the invitation. But people who know me read between the lines and knew that's what I meant. I'm not personally into all that hoopla at this point in my life. I never was, really. But anyway, we had a great time. Everybody said, man, this is such a great idea, not having to be strangled by a tie all night. And the women were saying not having to spend money on another outfit and be in heels and be uncomfortable. And we had a hundred, I think we had 182 people at that party. And that was a hoot. That was a good one. All right. Well, let's see how that works. Think I need to paint. Well, I've got a bunch of turquoise solid ones. So, how can I do this? Thanks, Afia. Good to see you too. Thanks for joining. All right, I'm gonna let that sit there. And these brushes. Gesso. Well, this is almost empty, so I'm going to use this. Get rid of this big bottle. That was the bottle, not the artist. Sit upside down here for a little bit. Let's check my shoe drying process. Yeah, that's still a little bit damp. All right. The jars are going to be for Chelsea's baby shower. I got to change the colors because last time we were going to do it was a little girl. Now she's pregnant with a little boy. So we're going to navy and turquoise instead of coral and turquoise. So while my shoe's drying, I thought I'd try to get some of this done because not the most fun thing to do on stream, but I got to do what I got to do because my time is so limited this month and next month that I got to get it done while I can. Yeah, it's weddings are so expensive. I've been married before. Dave was not. So I told him we do whatever you want to do, and he said, no, we'll do what you want to do. And I thought, well, I just as soon have a party and call it a day. So that's what we did. Ended up being two parties, but it's all right. All the better. We got engaged on 8/8/08, so we wanted to try to get married on 9/9/09. I don't know why we're not both very superstitious, but That's what we did. That pink's coming through a little bit. I might have to do a second coat on that. Although this one's kind of holding its own. Oh, but I wanted to do it with, I wanted to try one with stripes. See, that quick I forgot what the hell I was doing. So, oh, I mentioned earlier, and I want to do it while now I'm recording now. For the Maryland Art Weekend next year, I'm going to send an email out to the list of people I have that have gone before. And I'm going to start, not yet, but I'm going to just give everybody a heads up that I'm going to be starting to collect the deposits early to ensure we get the same room. That room worked out so nice, having it right in the hotel and adjacent to our sleeping rooms. It really worked out great. It was big enough for the size group we want. But that room books up fast. So in order to hold it, I have to have a signed contract, which requires the deposit being made. So I'll have to start collecting for the deposit sooner than later, or we risk the chance of losing that room or the dates for that room that I was trying to get. I was trying to do the same weekend, the last weekend of July again. That was available when I checked. So, if you were not ever at one of the weekends and you're interested, get in touch with me and I'll add your email address to the list when I send it out. Just as a heads up, the prices are probably going to go up a little bit this year. Hopefully not a lot, but to get our business, they gave us some freebies the last couple of years, which I was told they wouldn't be able to continue doing. You know how they covered the tables and the floor and the AV equipment I got for free. So I'm not sure what impact that's going to be. So it might go up a little bit. And if you have a project that you'd be interested in teaching, let me know that as well. CB, I think you should teach. You always do such great work. And since you're an alumni, I thought we'd mix it up a little bit and have other people. Several people mentioned to me that they'd like to do that. Oh, thanks, Joan. I'll don't send it yet. I don't want to have to start doing the accounting bit of it yet, but I'm going to send the email out soon and then probably start trying to drum it up after the holiday, which I know is a bad time for people after Christmas and they've spent more money than they usually spend. So I'll see what I can do. It may work out, it may not, but teach what? Teach anything that you do. Your stuff is awesome. You know what? I would love to know somebody that does watercolors that could teach like a basic beginner's watercolor class for selfish reasons, of course. That's what I'd say about me. Jack of all trades, master of zip. It doesn't have to be a full day thing. We can do half day little numbers. Just got to be mindful of people having to bring supplies and, you know, trying to do something that's not heavily different supplies for the different classes I end up with. That's why I'm saying if you got an idea or you want to do it, let me know and I'll see what looks like we can piece together. I think my friend Donna that was here with us last year, I think I can get her to do something. She's got really cool ideas and stuff and is a great teacher. Although she doesn't teach formally, but Patty, what kind of paint do you use on the shoes? Can you use a Here Fun to dry? I'm guessing that meant heat gun, Here Fun. you probably can, but it says they want to cure a little bit. Angelus is the brand. This is the cleaner and preparer, but it's Angelus is leather paint. All right, let's heat gun these bad boys a little bit. And after I paint these, the ones that are solid, I took a sandpaper and scrubbed off the high points so they look kind of distressed. I think they look really pretty when you paint the inside of the jar, too. Because the glass makes it look like it's got a high gloss finish on it. But I already had the outsides of all these painted. I guess I could try painting the inside of one of these turquoise. See what that looks like. Take care, Marie. Thanks for stopping by. I'd be curious to see what kind of acrylic she used for the doctor's shoes that she does that didn't crack. Maybe she uses this leather paint. I don't know. All right, let's try. These are all the same size. Where's the first one? This was drier. Just for giggles. Let's see what happens. Still wet. Let's see. This beach glass, Martha Stewart beach glass, is the one we used before. Yeah, they're going to have water in them. I mean, just for the day. And then I don't care what happens to them. Yeah, the luminaires make sense since they're like a fabric paint. That would work. Because they're, you know, fabric moves and they don't crack. So that probably would work. We never got into that. Have more. Look, another bottle. What luck. I'm going to probably have to get off of here by 2. This still a little tacky. I might have to finish this up on a follow-up stream. Hey, Pam. All right, let's just go for it, shall we? Again, it's not the artist. All right, I'm going to let this one sit upside down for a little bit. Let's go with this. Crap, it's got a sealer in there. Oh, Martha, look at you. All right, here goes nothing. Oh, it looks kind of cool, I think. Maybe. Who knows? Again, these colors aren't showing up just right on the screen. Right. Actually, I got a little bit too much paint in there. They're not coming across. I think they're prettier in person, Ella. Navy's coming out extra dark, and the turquoise, this is more like a, well, it's Martha Stewart Beach glass, if anybody knows what that's like. It's like a baby color turquoise. It's really soft and a pretty. Look what I did. I smudged one of them. I'll have to clean that up. All right. Actually, I think that'll do that to another one since I have all this extra paint out here. It also hides the pink underneath. Oh, shit. That wasn't dry either. Come on. Pay attention. See, it doesn't pay to hurry all the time. Patty, someone asked if the paint will peel due to the water. I have no idea. I would guess that it would, but I don't really care because we only have to have them last for about 4 or 5 hours. This isn't a permanent solution. This is just decoration for the day. In my eyes, that's what we're doing. I'm guessing that's completely possible and probable. Yeah, this isn't a permanent thing. I'm just trying to come up with a shower decoration for this tables. Trying to find the spots I missed. Right. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna put baby's breath in. Another layer on the one that's the driest. Get some stripes on this one, maybe. I certainly can't do it freehand. Unless I want to go with an organic abstract stripe, possibly. Kind of liking just the white. Maybe I'll do white and just some turquoise polka dots on it. Yeah, I'm not going to bake them. They're going to be what they're going to be. The shower's the Sunday after Thanksgiving, so they're going to have a lot of curing time. It's just that I don't have other time to do this later in the month because I'm not going to, I mean, November. I'll be gone a chunk of that time and come back to Thanksgiving, and then the shower's that Sunday, so these will have a good 3 weeks to cure. And whatever happens, happens. I'm not too worried about it. I'm sure she'll probably take a couple of her favorites as a keepsake. And if I have to redo them for her, I'll just redo them for her so they're more permanent. She might put one on her little shelf she made. Possibly. Feel pretty dry. Yeah, you know what? I think I might have a stencil of an anchor too. And that's actually one of the things we're going to do for the shower. It's nautical, right? To match the room and all that. Oh, and here's the shower invitation that I did with a little whale on it. All right, the whale and all that. And then this was the book where we're going to ask for a book instead of a greeting card if you want to do that. And then write a little note to the baby in the book. And then we did these tags I sent in with everybody's. It's got a little write-up there. And basically what this says is tradition is changing. And instead of wrapping all the gifts and having to spend 2 to 3 hours of her sitting there unwrapping and unwrapping and everybody just sitting there looking at each other, to bring the gifts unwrapped, you put this ta put a big bow on it if you want to, but leave it unwrapped so you can see what it is and hang this tag on it. And on the back, I have the person's name and address, a description of the gift in case it falls off, and wishes for the baby. And then we'll pull all these off and give them to Chelsea for the thank you cards. She'll have all the information for the thank yous right there instead of having, again, having somebody sit there and write down, you know, Aunt Patty got her this, you know, and all that kind of stuff. So we're going forward with more modern traditions on the shower as well. And that'll give Chelsea all the time to eat and socialize and talk to everybody and, you know, not focus on her just sitting there for hours, you know, opening gift after gift. So that's the plan. But yeah, I like that. I like that, Debbie. Putting a whale on one, putting a anchor on one. And what was the other thing? Let me see if I can find that. I bought these cupcake toppers. We're gonna do cupcakes. Purchases. I got them on Etsy. Here they are. Nope, won't blow up. There we go. So here's the cupcake toppers that we got. Sailboats, whales, and anchors. So that would be nice to make the jars kind of go with those. Good idea. So now, I know I don't have a whale stencil. Maybe I can just decoupage a whale on it. Aha. Right? I do have an anchor stencil somewhere. And I know iStencil sells them. Oh, I'm working on another iStencil release too. In my spare time. So I'm trying hard this time to have a second release of new pictographs. So we'll see how that goes. Chelsea got this wooden outline of a whale. It's plain and it's painted a little bit darker gray than the walls are in the nursery. And it's hanging over the wall above the crib. And with that lamp, the way it makes those water. Wait, what makes it looks like wave, like an underwater view. It looks really cool with that whale. That was all accidental, but it looks really cool with the whale. It looks like you can see him underwater. And it's not a real cartoony whale. It's pretty whale. If that makes any sense. As I'm saying it, it doesn't, but kind of keeping with my program. Not much I say or do makes sense sometimes. Just when you thought you could save your money. What are you getting, Gala? What are you spending it on this time? Don't blame it on me. I don't think I recommended any products, did I? Crap, I got my sleeve in the gesso. Dag on it. Oh, I love spending your money. Way more than I like spending mine. But I don't know what I'm making you spend it on this time. I know last time I got you on that fancy ink and that glass dip pen. But you gotta admit you like them, right? Oh, I'll show you something else I just got. I haven't gotten much recently. After my last little splurge, I did get the I did buy some new supplies for Jody's Zen painting class. I got the gesso boards and the different writing instruments that she recommends and that you need to do these techniques. All right, three white ones. Patty whale shape, very simple cut your own stencil and X-Acto. Yeah, I could do that. Oh yeah, and Pine, and when we were shopping in Southern Pines, we went in this really cool little shop. Gala got a really pretty scarf with sugar skulls on it. It was really elegant, if you can picture a sugar skull being elegant. And they had these real thin, soft, woven cotton blankets that were swaddling blankets, for infants. And the one I got was pure white with gray whales about this big, kind of splashed over it. It was re it's like it'll go perfect with the nursery. Right. Do I want to maybe put white inside of this one? Or just leave that one clear? Don't know. Alrighty. Oh, I have some just turquoise dots. I wonder if I should put white in this one and see what that looks like. I got three of these. Or about painting like navy stripes on one of these that's painted solid turquoise. Oh yeah, I'm tapping my fingers. I was told not to do that. The very angry viewer who didn't like me when I do this, when I think, uh-uh. I do it anyway though, because I just, that's what I do. That's what I do. I'm going to put white inside this one. Maybe I'll put white dots on this one, or navy stripes, or nothing. Who the hell knows what I'll do? I'll just burn up the rest of this gesso. Beggar's Night. I never heard Halloween called Beggar's Night either. But where I used to live in my row house, before I moved in with Dave, was a heavily populated area. We would get 500 kids per night. And we know this because the neighbor next door were they were elderly and they bought a little bag of lollipops, suckers we call them. The little cheapy ones where you can get 500 in a bag. And each child got one, and when they were done, they'd go in for the night. And they burned through that bag every time I lived there for 7 years, and every time they burned through it. So, what I was going to say is, I love seeing the little kids come in, but when you get the kids that are still knocking on your door, that have a 5 o'clock shadow that's not a costume and carrying around a pillowcase and no costume on to come and get more candy because they like your candy. That's when I would call it beggar's night. Go home. I know you're 16. And the store's closed for the night. Thank you. You've been here twice already. I'll let you get away with that. That's what I don't like. If you got to shave, you're probably too old to trick or treat. Just my 2 cents. Here we get, well, for years we got three kids, the same three kids. One family down the street. Last year we got five. My husband, God love him, he still buys the gigantic bag of chocolate bars from Costco. Guess where they end up? Get some duct tape, tape them right to my ass because that's where they're going. But no, I make them take them to work the day after Halloween to get rid of them. Like, we're only going to get 5 kids. He insists that it's cheaper to buy them that way. And so they each get a fistful when they come here. But we do have some new kids in the neighborhood, so we'll see how that goes. All right. Oh, that looks pretty cute. That looks very babyish. Let's see. See that one? That's kind of cute. And this looks blue, baby blue, but it's not. It's baby beach glass. It's very greeny turquoise. So, I'm just trying to mix them up a little bit. There we have it. Do I like that enough? Should I leave one plain navy? I'm running out of plain jars. That's why I thought I had more jars over there, but I don't think I do. Tape it on. Oh, that was lagged. I forgot about the candy comment. I thought you meant tape something on here. I was, oh no, she's talking about my ass. All right, what am I doing? Blue sponge and some water before that's a goner. This one's too blah. It needs something. I think I'm going to put smaller polka dots in the white on that. There's my little polka dotty tool. There we go. That'll work. Yeah, it looks kind of baby blanketish, doesn't it? Put some white. I'm just going to use gesso. I should probably sand that first. Let's see. Where's my... No, I had... Here it is. I'll use this one. Someone recommended filling the jar with blue water. Yeah, that would work. That would work. See, and then you just get the little bit of the relief showing there for the high spot. See, it looks a little more distressed. And then no pink for this one. Yeah, I love these little pouncers. There in that relief area. There we go. That's what that one's going to look like. And tapping, I'm tapping. They're undecided on the name yet. Got a couple contenders, but I think they're just not gonna publicize it until they're ready. My Anderson. I get one of these dry enough. Maybe if I heat the inside of it, it'll help dry it through and cure it a little bit. We'll see if just using washi tape on it'll work. Maybe not. Well, here's this other stuff I was going to show you guys. I saw KP using this art graph. It's watercolor graphite in this little pot. And she just water brush and went in and dipped it and used it black as a trimming out some wood little plaques that she or wood paintings that she did. Have to try that. That was kind of cool, cute. Thought I had to have some. Okay, what am I gonna do? I'm gonna try to do crap. How many times have I said that so far today? Crappity, crap, crap. No matter how big my table is, it's never big enough. Orla, how are you? All right, let's see how this works. Let me get some washi. The wider stuff, but I hate to use my good stuff, my favorites. Not like I ever use them. Do I want it that wide? No. Well, let's just hang on. Hold the phone. I don't know what I'm so worried about. I never use this stuff anyway. So let's get over the not using it and just bust it out and go for it. How about that? Oops, what's going on here? Oh, okay. Well, that's different. Now, let's see if I can put this on straight. Oral, I was just telling everybody I'm going to be sending out an email soon about next year's art weekend. I need to start collecting deposits earlier if I want to get that same room because it books quickly. You know what? I don't know that this is going to work because of this curve on here. I might have to freehand it. Well, they're going to be kind of abstract anyway. Apparently. I can't tape straight. And that's okay. Doesn't make me a bad person. Let's put one here and one at the bottom. And no, I want three navy stripes. One, two. We'll just do it like this. You think it helps talking to myself? You may not think it does, but I don't think it does. And you know what? I don't think this is going to keep it from running under. I'll burnish it a little bit when I get it on here. Well, that's still just two. Can't count either. I'll put one on the bottom. I'll make the navy, the bottom navy. And I can see they're crooked. But so is Aunt Pappy. So, let's just press on, shall we? All right. Oh, did Orla say she's not going to be able to come next year? I must have missed something. Oh, mercy. All right, here goes nothing. Here we go. Do blue, blue, blue. Maybe I'll just do the whole top blue too. I don't know. Let's just see if I can get this much on without totally dinking it up. Trying to brush away from the tape to try to cause less bleeding under it. I don't know if that's going to help or not. Maybe the crooked lines will make them more endearing. They're handmade. I'm not a machine, people. All right. I'm surprised Babe and Mojo haven't been down here. I've been down here over 3 hours now. All right, I'm going to do the bottom blue. Use the light blue Martha paint for the top and bottom. Oops. Oh, embrace the lag. Yeah, I think they are snoozing up there, Joan. When I left, Mojo was on the bed and Babe was back in her little corner in the bedroom, snoozed out. One, two, three. Do I want to put another top blue? No, I think that would be too much. Okay. Look at that executive decision I made, just like that. Now, I'm going to pull the tape off now. See what the damage is. Oh, so far, not bad. Where did I overlap that one? Where are you? What the heck? There we go. That way. There we go. Look what happened. Ah! That whole piece is coming off where that emblem is, but if it comes off even, I'll be able to use that to my advantage. Look what I did. Ha ha! How clever of me that I was able to do that. So much for having tooth. Well, that's a... Well, it started out a happy accident. We'll see where it ends up. Ha! Look how that came off! That's the inside of the jar. It was coral from the last time. I couldn't do that again if I tried. That's crazy. Now I probably should paint the back of the thing blue so when you look through it, you don't see the pink. Maybe just a little bit. Don't have to do the whole inside. Ay, ay, ay. Nope, that's the wrong brush. Let's use this one. Actually, I don't want that little brush. I want the bigger brush. Wasn't that clever? Not a word you hear much in my vocabulary. Yes, I knew that was going to happen. Yeah, that's right. I knew it. Now let's get it to be matchy-matchy inside. Hopefully this will cover up over the pink and not make me sorry I'm doing this.
Oops, I got a big paint booger in there. Once they get flowers and stuff in here, you're not gonna see the back of it anyway. Depends on the angle. I gotta paint a little bit more.
Barb, I'm repainting my shoes I painted and failed with last year, and that's drying and curing while I'm catching up on baby shower mason jars for my niece's baby shower coming up. So now I got teal in the background of that one. So there you go. That's kind of like the navy and white ones. Maybe I should do another one. Bigger one polka dotted, perhaps. Let's see. Maybe I'll do some stripes in the teal. Since that was a success in the navy. Oh my gosh, they were brutal to get that paint off of them. The other one, I'm just going to do another time. It would have been the whole stream, me trying to get the paint off these old shoes. It was, for something that cracked so easy, it was very difficult to get off when I wanted it to come off. It doesn't seem right. That's better. And these may be a little wonky because of all the curves and the imprint, the raised bits on here. And we're just going to go with it. I'm not a measurer, as we all know. This one I'm going to get. It was a great idea at the time. But see, this is the one that's left that I did last year. See the cracks? That was one wear. They started to crack and peel like that after wearing them one day. Don't think that didn't hack me off. So now, here's where I am, and I'm using leather paint this time. So I just got a base layer down there for now, and that's feeling drier now, actually. All right, let's do this. These will be different size stripes. And I'll get my three stripes in there. All right. Now, any more beach glass? Is there any left in there? Try that. I know, I loved them for the 2 hours they lasted. Hopefully this is going to last a little bit better, is that they are leather paints and they are used to paint shoes. So that little bending, actually those shoes are so stiff. I didn't think that they would been that much, to be honest. All right. I'm going to do this one. And then I'm going to need to take a break. Because I'm getting a little hungry and not feeling wonderful. Should have eaten more before I started. But it has been over 3 hours. It's been 3.5 hours, so. Those just joining, I did not hit the record button. It's been so long since I streamed, I forgot how to stream. I forgot to hit the record, but all you missed really was me scrubbing the paint off of one of the shoes, trying every tactic known to man, and Rihanna came up with the idea of using duct tape to pull off some of the tape, and that's what really worked the best in the end. All right. I love this color. I wish it looked like the right color. That looks like real baby blue to me on the screen, but it's a really pretty minty turquoise, baby shade of turquoise. This is one of the colors we used in Chelsea's wedding centerpieces that we did the mason jars for. All right. Thanks, Barb. Yeah, she's had a rough go of it. It was really rough again last week. But this week, she's doing much better. You can see her personality coming back where she's feeling better. Took her in for more blood work Thursday, and the vet said, you know, she's doing really well for, she said she was a really sick pup. And she's doing, you know, really well, all things considered. And we're not out of the woods. They think it's an autoimmune disease that may come back at any time, as they do. And but right now we're treating the symptoms and trying to keep her pain-free and happy. And as long as we can do that, we will do that. But it's good to see her wagging her tail and look. Not so much on that one. That was my initial concern on the first one. Oh, and that one bled all over. Yeah, this one might be one for the... Maybe I should have let it dry more. Where the hell's the end of the tape? Here we go. Yeah, look. Okay. That's what I thought would have happened because of the jar not being glass and not having any tooth, even though it had layers of gesso on there. Actually, this one looks like it just had a first layer of paint. Okay, well, let's scrap this one. And we shall try that again. Perhaps another day. Wow, look at that. Like peeling a sunburn. Yeah, we'll do the best we can for as long as we can, Barb, but we've already decided we're not putting her through another surgery. The last one she had last year was brutal, and here we are a year later. it was, she had over 200 staples last year from that mast cell cancer tumor they took out and had to graft skin from her belly on her leg. It was a mess. And we're not going to put her through chemo if it turns out they find out that she has cancer. We did an ultrasound of her belly and there was no cancer there. That's not saying there isn't any in her head or under her rib cage, but that's a different test. So we will keep her happy and her tail wagging and give her as much love as possible for as long as we can. And when we have to do the right thing by her, that's what we'll do, as much as that will suck. That is painter. Oh, no, that wasn't. Sorry, that was washi tape. The black that I used on my shoes, that was the painter's tape. Maybe I should have used that. Shoulda, coulda, woulda. I think if I get this back to the glass, I'll start with gesso on this one again and let it just sit here and cure for a little bit until I can come back another day and hit them again. I kind of like peeling it, though, I got to tell you. Thanks, Barb. Yeah, not easy thing to do, but, you know, we know that when we get them, that they have a short lifespan, but they just, you know, they bring you so much love and joy while you have them that it's worth the loss when you have to let them go. But they have had a wonderful life, I can tell you that. And to think we were turned down by a lab rescue place when we first started thinking about getting a dog. We were not suitable candidates because we said that at some point we'd like to bring another dog into the house. So they nixed us. Right, Denise? No kidding. Oh, Elmer's glue with the paint. That's not something I ever thought about. Thanks, Ella. You guys have all these smart ideas. This actually won't ruin my nails. It'll be a lot of scrubbing to get back down to them, but it usually comes off pretty quick. As it's coming off this jar. See, this is one that we did for the wedding originally, and it was painted, I think it's actually called wedding cake, the color, but see how it looks glossy because it's under the glass, where this one looks more matte because it's over the glass. This was one of our samples. Chelsea liked the distressed ones better, so this one was in the abandoned pile. So, how many lessons did I give you today on what not to do? I mean, you gotta love that. Yeah, we were turned down. We were looking at a dog. I'll never forget him. It was a yellow lab. His name was Rocky. And it said in his profile that he loves other dogs and gets along well with other dogs and loves, you know, being around a second dog. And they had a home visit scheduled to come out. And, did that go? They had a home visit scheduled to come out, and the one that we'd been talking to was ill and couldn't make it. It was in the winter, and they called a substitute in to call us for directions. So they called us for directions, and they asked us a couple questions while we were on the phone, and it came up about, I forget what the question was, but I'm looking at the chat. I'm trying doing too many things. My brain's dead. They asked us about something that made us talk about, you know, at some point after this dog is very comfortable in our house and he's adjusted, that we would like to get another dog for him to have company. And they said, you want to get another dog? I said, well, you know, down the road, 6 months to a year, depending on, you know, how this one adjusts and making sure this one's healthy and everything and happy. And I said, you know, in his profile, it said he likes playing with other dogs. I said, oh, I'm going to have to call you back. So he goes away. And when he calls back, he said, well, I'm not going to be able to make it over tonight. And it was just a weird exit the way he said that. And so I emailed the lady that was in charge of the whole works to find out when someone would be coming. And she said, well, now that we know that you are interested in getting a second dog, you're no longer qualified as a candidate to take this dog. And I was like, whoa, whoa, back it up, baby. We already told you that. And it says in his profile that he likes other dogs. And, you know, from then on, she never responded to another email and just let us hang in there. And that really jacked me up. I thought, you know what? You don't have the nerve to try to come back. And, oh, in his profile, it said he was found eating out of a dumpster. And in one of my emails, I said, I'm pretty sure we can do better than having the dog eat out of a dumpster. But anyway, so we didn't get Rocky, and then we went on and we just thought, well, the hell with it. We'll just go buy our yellow lab pup. And we got Mojo, and then we got Knucklehead 6 months later. So, and we love him to death. But poor Rocky missed having a really good home. These guys are spoiled rotten and you know, are very well taken care of. But we're supposed to have the two we got. Yeah, it was ridiculous. Like, are you kidding me? So, yeah, that's the story. But I'm gonna wrap up, guys, because I need to get something to eat before I tank. And that's never pretty. And I don't know if I, depending on what I get done, I may come back down and mess with my shoe a little bit more later. So I'll tweet and I'll put it on Facebook if I do. If not, we're probably looking at hoping for next Sunday. I don't know what the date is, but I think that's okay. November 6th, 7th. I don't know what it is. Anyway, I'm hoping to try to get back on some kind of a normal schedule and squeeze a couple hours in here and there. Isn't that crazy, Barb? I wish somebody would watch your streams and see how you treat your cats. That they wouldn't let you adopt two cats. That's ridiculous. I don't know who makes these decisions and how they vet the people that really want the dog. I mean, I'm sure there are people that have bad intentions, but I would think there would be much less of them than people with good intentions wanting to do the right thing. But we can adopt Nancy. Oh, gosh. So anyway, I'm going to wrap it up, guys. And it was great being back for a little while. Hopefully I can do it again next Sunday. And I'll catch you later. Thanks for hanging with me. Bye.